वेलकम अगेन टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल इजी एजुटेक। माई सेल्फ आई एम शैलेश कुटेकर फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। नाउ वी हैव टू मूव टू द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज द यूजेस एंड एनवायरमेंटल इफेक्ट ऑफ पॉलीहेड्रोजन कंपाउंड। सो इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट हियर। Now, what is the polyhalogen compound? The compound which containing two or more halogens is called as polyhalogen compound. So, we have to discuss the environmental uses and environmental effect of the polyhalogen compound. So, here these are the six polyhalogen compound which is mentioned in our here textbook. In our textbook, this uses and environmental effect is given directly. So it is difficult to understand and to be right also. So what I have to use some technique how we have to write, discuss this by using the physical properties. What is the physical property? Remember one thing, in chemistry if you have to discuss the physical property of any elements or chemical compound, then this physical property are discussed on the basis of the six parameters. What are they? These are the first upon state. We have to discuss the state of any element, that is the solid, liquid and gas. Then second one is the color. Then next one is the order. Then next one is the here melting and boiling point. Note down this point, which is most important. Next one is the solubility. Next one is the here density. So these are the six parameters. On the basis of this, we have to discuss the physical property of any element. Remember this forever. Then we have to discuss here these compounds, that is the polyhalogen compound here, by using the uses. General uses we have to discuss, it may be 1, 2 or 3. Then we have to discuss the environmental effect of these compounds. I can abbreviate this, environmental effect of this compound. Now what is the environmental effect? Environmental effect, that is the effect of this polyhalogen compound on all matters which come under the environment. In environment, there is from man, woman, animal, insect, soil, atmosphere, all these things which is come in under the environment. So we have to discuss the effect, environmental effect of this compound on that matter. So it is important. So let's we have to start with the here first polyhalogen compound, that is the methylene dichloride. This methylene dichloride is the polyhalogen compound, because it having the here formula CH2Cl2, we can write just like this, CH2Cl2. So this is the methylene dichloride. Now initially, as for our sequence, we have to discuss here the physical property. It is very simple. But how is this methylene dichloride? It is a colorless volatile liquid which having the sweet smell. That means it have no color. It is the volatile in the nature, that is volatile liquid, and it having the sweet smell. So it is regarding the here three parameters that of the physical property. It is important. Yeah. Then next one, what is the general uses of this? In general, how it is used? It is used as a solvent. It is used as a solvent. What is the role of the solvent? The solvent is used for making the solution. And it is also used as a propellant in aerosols. What is mean by propellant in the aerosol? All of you are use the perfume or spray. When we have to use the perfume or spray, we have to observe that in a spray, there is a knob just like this. We have to see it in the butter. When we have to press this knob, here gas is to be moved outside. How it is moved outside? Because here, inside this spray, there is present a liquid. That liquid can exert a pressure on the gas, and gas can be moved outside. The substance which can exert a pressure on the gas in the aerosol can. And so this methylene dichloride is used as a propellant. So this is the general use of this. Now, then we have to discuss the next point, that is the environmental effect. Overexposure of this, when it is exposed overly, all over in the surrounding, it causes headache, it causes weakness to human being, it causes fatigue. What is meant by fatigue? The mental stress on the mental stress to the human being. It causes nausea. Nausea means vomiting sensation. So we have to say just like this. On overexposure, it causes headache, fatigue, weakness, and nausea. Next one is the here. It is dangerous for our eyes. It can affect the or it can damage the cornea of the eye. The hydrogen compound, that is the chloroform. This chloroform has a formula CHCl3. Trichloromethane, it is called as chloroform. So, how is the chloroform? Chloroform kaisa hai? So, chloroform also here, colorless liquid which having the sweet smell. Physical property of chloroform, when we have to discuss, it is a colorless in the nature, it is liquid in, it is in the liquid form, and it is sweet in smell. So it is important here. Now, what is the general uses of this chloroform? We have to discuss. It is used for making the CFM, that is a chlorofluoromethane. This chlorofluoromethane, in general, generally it is abbreviated or it is shown by the R22. And this R22 or chlorofluoromethane is a refrigerant. That means it is used for cool the refrigerator. So it is important here. Next one, it is used, use of this, it is used as a solvent extraction for the natural product like gum, fats, resins, etc. That means if you have to extract the fats from the oil, then we have to use the air chloroform. So it is used as a solvent extraction from the natural product. So it is important here. So in this way, this is the here uses general uses of this. Then what is the environmental effect? It is important here. It causes here depression on central nervous system. This one is that on inhaling, it causes the unconsciousness. If you have to inhale this in our body, it can cause the unconsciousness. So it is important here. And last one, which is important here, when it is come in contact with the air, there is a formation of dangerous gas, that is the fuzzing. And so it is always kept in a dark color bottle with the airtight piston. So in this way, we have to discuss the effect and environmental effect of the chloroform. It is important here. Next, oleogen compound is the carbon tetrachloride. This carbon tetrachloride has the formula CCl4. So it is important here. Now, what is the physical property of this? This carbon tetrachloride also here, colorless liquid which having the sweet smell. All these first three have the same physical property. It is to be noted here. It is important here. Then, what is the general use of this? It is used as a solvent in the fats and oils. What is the role of solvent here? If you have to observe regarding the oil, in oil it is used as a solvent. That means what happened? Government have due authority to oil mills and any oil company that they have to use the 40% other substance, that is the solvent. And in such cases, such a carbon tetrachloride is used as a solvent. For instance, of the chlorine, as it contains large number of chlorine, so it is the source of the chlorine. And as it is the source of the chlorine, next application which is important, chlorine is used as a cleansing agent. So it is also act as a cleansing agent. Carbon tetrachloride is the cleansing agent. It is important here. So these are the here general uses of the here carbon tetrachloride. Then what is the environmental effect? So it is important here. When it is toxic, first we have to discuss, it is toxic in the nature. So it is toxic to the liver also. if it is inhaled or it is moved in our body, it is toxic to the liver also. Then second is that it is affect on the central nervous system. It is affect on the central nervous system, and one thing is most important, it is a carcinogenic in the nature. That is why carcinogenic in nature, it is a cancer causing substance. So it is a carcinogenic in the nature. And last one is that it is a responsible for the greenhouse effect. That is, it is the greenhouse gas actually. So it is important. So in this way, we have to discuss the environmental effect of the carbon tetrafluoride. Now we have to move to the next compound, polyhalogen compound, that is the iodoform. This iodoform have the formula here, CHI3. So it is important here. Now initially we have discussed the physical property of the iodoform, which we have to discuss about the polyhalogen compound. So this iodoform is the pale yellow crystalline solid, and it having very bad light. It is the pale yellow crystalline solid which having very bad smell. So it is important. Now what is the general uses of this iodoform? Iodoform have very important in our daily life. It is used as a healing agent. माने अगर किसका accident हो जाता है तो body का कोई organ जो है वो थोड़ा heal यानी सूजन से आ जाती है. To reduce that, it is used as a healing agent. Second thing, it is a antiseptic in the nature, so it is used for dressing of any wounds. So it is the general use of this. Now, what is the environmental effect of this iodoform? It causes here irritations to the skin and the eyes. अगर यहाँ पे skin में कहीं पे लग गया तो अपने skin में झुनझुनापन महसूस होता है. So it causes irritation in that. If our hand can be moved in across our eyes during the application of this such ointment which containing the iodoform, then it also causes irritation in our eyes. So it is important. Then here, this is the, I have already said, it have very bad smell. When it is inhaled, it can cause the here disorder or it is problem in the respiratory system. It may cause nausea, that means vomiting sensation. It may cause depression to the central nervous system. So it is important here. And second, most important, I have already said, visual disturbance is caused due to this iodoform. So in this way, they are the environmental effect of the iodoform. Now we have to move toward the freon. Now we have to discuss the next polyhalogen compound, that is the freon. It is somewhat different as compared to the compound which we have to discuss here. Now freon is nothing but the, it's a combination of the chlorine and the carbon. So it also called as CFC, chlorine, fluorine, carbon. But here it is represented as freon 12. This freon 12 is nothing but the dichloro diafluoromethane. So it is important here. Now what is the general use of this? General use of this freon is it is used as a refrigerant in the fridge as well as in the air conditioning or conditioner. That means it is used as a cooling agent. So it is important. Second use is that it is used as a blowing agent for making a foam. When the foam is formed here, it is used as a blowing agent. Due to that, the spongy nature of the foam we have to observe. So this is the application of the freon. Now what is the environmental effect of the freon? This is responsible for the here ozone layer depletion. Actually what happened? During the consumption of the freon, if you have to use the refrigerator or air conditioning, chlorofluorocarbon is evolved in the atmosphere. Chlorofluoromethane, which containing the chlorine here, it is evolved in the atmosphere. When it is moved in atmosphere and come in contact with the air UV light, then this chlorine is to be free. This chlorine, one atom of the chlorine can destroy the here 1 lakh atom of the here ozone. And due to that, here ozone layer is to be here degraded. So it is responsible for the depletion of the ozone layer. It is important. Second thing, it is inhaling by large amount due to excessive work in the air conditioning, it may cause the here breathing problem, or it may cause the unconsciousness. So many times it is observed that those persons are working in the air conditioner or air AC, they have the breathing problem. So this is the environmental effect which is most important. Now we have to move to the next one, that is the DDT. Here DDT stand for the dichloro diphenyl trichloroethane. So it is important here. Now here this DDT is the colorless, odorless, tasteless crystalline solid. The physical property when you have to observe, it is the colorless in nature, it is the tasteless, it have no odor. So it is the colorless, tasteless, odorless, and it is the crystalline solid. So it is important. Now general uses of the DDT we have to observe all over. It can kill the house fly. हमारे घर में जो मक्खियाँ होती है उसको किल करने का काम ये DDT कर सकता है. इट कैन किल द इंसेक्ट, इट कैन किल द मॉस्किटो. मच्छर जो होते हैं उनको किल करने के लिए DDT का यूज होता है. नेक्स्ट वन इज दैट इट कंट्रोल द मलेरिया. इट कैन इफ इट इज किल द मॉस्किटो एंड वी आर ऑब्वियसली से इट्स कंट्रोल द मलेरिया. सो दिस इज द जनरल यूजेस ऑफ दिस. इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट हियर. नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस here the next part, that is the environmental effect of this. So it is important. First of all, it is the here on highly exposure, it can due to that highly exposure it may cause or nausea. That means there is a vomiting sensation we have to observe. Then this is the first news we have to observe here. Then second one is that here it can show adverse effect on our liver. It can show the adverse effect on the liver on highly exposure, or if it is moved inside our body, it can damage our liver. So it is important. And next and last environmental effect we have to discuss here. When it is falls on any soil, it is absorbed by the soil. And if it is absorbed by the soil, the insect which are present in the soil, it is to be killed. That means it is totally damaged the ecosystem. The environmental effect of the polyhalogen compound. And dear friends, if you have to understand all these things better, then you have to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification of all the educational videos. Not only educational videos, but the videos regarding the entrance examination, as well as their guidance of the entrance examination, and also easy technique to know the here chemistry. So it is important.